Well, I'll tell you what, I'm going to be super warm in the woods tonight. I'm camping in the Iron Wall Black Walker tent, Windfighter's tent. It's a new tent to me, first time I've used it. But in my last camping video, I camped in my Polish teepee and I used this Woods Walker stove. I bought this stove, very happy with it. I've used it about 5 or 6 times now. And after I done the video showing my stove, the manufacturers contacted me and said, would I be interested in taking a look at another stove they've got? So they sent this to me for free. And I said, yeah, I'll take a look at it. Couldn't really turn it down because it's a fantastic stove. And I said, I'll look at it and I'll show it on the channel, provided I can be honest about it with no strings attached. And William from the company, he said, no problem at all. Use the stove, let us know what you think about it, show it to your viewers. And so that's what I'm going to do. You've also got to bear in mind that when it comes to hot tent camping and these lightweight titanium stoves, that I've only got experience of the Woods Walker brand. I haven't used or tried any other brand. I've not seen any other brand close up. So, I'm not super qualified, shall we say, to know what's good or what's bad about them. I've got a good eye. I've got a good understanding about certain things. And I immediately, when I saw them, I thought to myself, well, they're extremely well made, and they are very, very well made stoves. They're very light. The smaller one weighs 6.5 pounds. I'm not so sure on the weight of the larger one, but you know, there I'm picking it up with my little pinky. So I'd say it's probably about 1 pound heavier, 7.5, maybe 8 pounds. Where to buy them online? Your best bet is to look around, because I think the prices do vary. And someone left a comment saying that they managed to find one for a ridiculously cheap price. But I know when I bought the first stove, I paid £260 for it. So anyway, I'm going to unpack this stove now. This one hasn't even been burnt in. It's brand spanking new. And I'll unpack this one. I'll put them side by side so you can see them both together. This one has a very useful additional feature, which you'll see. This is the brand new stove. It's a bit larger, but there's two ways that you can use it. It comes with all the instructions. This is how it will come. You see, I've got the flue. It's brand spanking new. I've not even formed it yet, but I'll hopefully show you how to do that in a minute. Let's get the stove unpacked and assembled. So that's the stoves side by side. So you can probably see this one's probably 4 or 5 inches longer. Now, width-wise and height-wise, they're identical. They both share the same door at the front. They're both ridiculously lightweight. As I say, this one's 6.5 pounds. This one's probably a pound heavier. maybe £7. Just peel off the safety protective thing on the glass. But this stove can be configured in two different configurations. One is a big wood burner like this, where you use the whole body of the stove for your firewood, and they reckon that with hardwood and controlling the burn rate, you should be able to get about 5 hours burning on one loading. But the other one is that for about 2 minutes of modification, it comes with a few other little parts, and you can turn it into a wood burner at the front. And on the back, is it got an oven? So there's a compartment in here which is away from the flames. The flames come up, they go around and out through the chimney, and they don't get into this area here. So you've got an oven, you've got a thermometer. Absolute game changer, I think. You can come into the woods now and you can do some baking. I think it's brilliant. So anyway, I need to get the flue pipe formed. I need to burn this stove in. I will do it in the tent, but I'll make sure that I'm not in there in case it gives off any nasty gases. The tent is very well vented. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to roll the pipe now. There's a way you've got to do it. You can do it single-handedly if you follow this technique. Let's just get this off first. It can be quite springy, it can be sharp, so you should really wear gloves. I've got gloves here, which I might wear in a minute. The secret starts from the very get-go, and that is to turn it around and then roll it against itself. That's in camera shot, so I'm basically rolling it against itself. So basically you've rolled it around itself the other way, and then just press it to form a slight new shape and take off that memory of it being rolled up, and then it'll lie flat when you unroll it. Perfect. So we've got the rings handy, put them there, put the gloves on. Because this stuff is sharp, and then it's just a matter of starting in a corner and starting to roll it. Sliding these on now. You see that I'm working all the way along, doing it all single-handed. Doesn't look too elegant at the moment, but don't worry about that. It'll all sort itself out. So now it's that matter of just rolling it the opposite way now.
patient.
So there we are, literally about 3 minutes later. There's my pipe. And I've all single-handed and folded into the shape it needs to be in the woods on my own. Now, if I was to undo that, it would spring back and go all over the place again. But once you've fired it, once you run the stove and it's burnt it, it has a memory, it'll keep that memory. So when you come to assemble it into a pipe again, it will just go very, very, very quickly. So I think the next thing to do is get the stove in the tent, get this up, get the spark arrestor on, and get a fire going in that stove to burn it in. The collar goes in and turns and locks itself into place. You've got a little wing nut and a jubilee clip to hold that in. There's a slot in the back for the flue damper control. It just goes in there like that and limits the amount of draft. I do notice that when I was using my other one, if I had it fully in, it did smoke a bit. So you've got to find the ideal position for that. And also, it doesn't matter how hot the stove gets, if you hold that by the ring, it doesn't get hot at all. You can still manipulate it and do what you've got to do. Well, I gathered this wood, actually it was when I was here camping last. So I had a little stash that I'd put aside, but I need to find some more. But this length of stick here, with the stove configured as an oven, that's about the maximum length you want to be putting in. So just about hand, length of the hand and half again at the most. I'm going to use the old paraffin lamp and a piece of kitchen towel to get the stove going. A few twigs in to start it off. This is my first stove. I've burnt it 5 or 6 times now, and there is a very slight warp with the roof, but when you put it all together, and it goes together very easily, you can see it all tightens itself up and straightens itself up and does what it's supposed to do. So that's the only slight issue, but I think they all warp up to a point. But if I could improve the design, I think I'd probably put maybe some supporting ribs across the front here on the top, just to stop that. But I'm really super happy with this stove, and so the new one is burning in nicely at the moment. Okay, so what I'm noticing with the oven, it's struggling to get up to temperature when you burn it with the bigger pieces of wood. I think it needs smaller wood to get it up to speed for when you want to do any roasting. Let's see if this brings it up to temperature. Certainly putting out sufficient heat from the firebox, and the kettle's boiling nicely. But the oven, I'm not seeing it reach temperatures that I want. Not at the moment. Let's see if it does it with the smaller stuff. You can see the with the smaller wood on, it's beginning to pick up now in the oven, so maybe we're going to be all right after all. I was a bit concerned. I'm going to roast these potatoes, so parboil them first and then roast them. I've got the stove burning quite hard now. Loaded up with a lot of fuel. It's got a vigorous boil going. This is boiling like crazy now. Absolutely like crazy. The oven's slowly getting there. So that's the temperature in the oven. I imagine it'd be hotter to one side and hotter on the top, and it could be colder on this corner here. So the thing is it going to be hot enough to roast the potatoes? That's just it. So I'm going to get the spuds into the oven now and see if it works. 160 degrees centigrade at the moment. So that's getting there, isn't it? Ah, problem. That doesn't fit. Right, back to the drawing board. So as you just saw, my lid didn't fit, so I've used the lid for my kettle, the GSI kettle. So that fits in there, with a little bit of coconut oil for fat. We'll see how it goes. I'm having no problem cooking my food on the top. I've had it going for quite some time now, been a good hour, and I just can't get the gauge on the front there to go much above 100 degrees centigrade. But I've got a feeling what's happening is that this part of the oven's probably quite cool, but right at the back of the oven, I think it's a lot hotter, because the potatoes in there are starting to roast, so I think it's just a matter of having to keep turning the actual contents around, turning the little tray round, and making sure that they get the even temperature sort of thing, you know. Let's get a stick and open this up. Yeah, they definitely are roasting. You can see they're roasting in there. So it is in the back, it's hot, it's just right at the very front, and that's the sensor there, so it's not giving you an accurate reading to the actual temperature in the oven. After about half an hour, that's what the roasters look like, so if I give them another half an hour, I think they'd have crisped up even better. So yeah, it was, it's doing something. Nice big thick gravy. Well, that's going to go down well. shan't be using the stove in the morning when I strike camp, because it takes too long for them to cool down, so I got my little folding firebox for that. But I want these pieces of bread tomorrow. These are sort of, you've got to finish them off in the oven sort of thing, you know. So they can go in there tonight, and we'll see what they've cooked like. Still not getting a very good reading on that dial, but I put the pieces of bread in there about half hour ago. And you can see, it's hot. That's one. There's the other one. So, yeah, the oven's working. It does work. Well, I've retired to the warmth of the shelter and the stove, putting out some lovely warmth now. Just beautiful. Oh, it's getting a bit parky out there. So, just going to sit in here, enjoy the ambience. I've got the kettle on, let's have a cup of coffee in a minute. It's still quite early, it's not 5 o'clock yet. So I've had my dinner, I've washed up, I've got enough wood in for the evening. I've got my bed all sorted out. I'm on a camping cot and a cloud-based inflatable mat, plus my Ram 700 sleeping bag. I think I'm going to have a lovely evening. Stove ticking over beautifully, just chucking out the right amount of heat. Well, what can I say? I've changed the stoves over. I've now gone back to the smaller stove because I think it's just a better stove. It's got a better sized firebox. I'm sure that the big stove with the oven, if you take the oven compartment out, I'm sure it'd be massive. I'm sure it'll work brilliant, but it would be just too big a stove for this little tent that I'm in. So I've opted for the smaller Woods Walker stove, which is just for me, just the right size. It's kicking out tremendous heat. Even this little stove belting heat out. I had to do some more wood gathering, and the moon's out and it's getting quite chilly out there, but I'll tell you what, it is now in here roasting hot. Anyway, I'm gonna lie down and just enjoy the warmth. Mm-hmm. Oh, it was a good sleep. It was a very good sleep. Well, in conclusion, for me personally, this stove is absolutely ideal. It's the ideal size for me. It bangs out tons of heat. It's just the right stove for me. On the other hand, the larger stove with the oven, I found the oven to have hot and cold spots. The firebox is about half, with the oven installed, the firebox takes up about half the size of the stove. And you can remove the thermometer and you can make it into one big stove. In that case, it would really, really bang the heat out, but that would be just too much for my shelter, you know, it would be too much heat. So for me personally, I think I'll use the smaller stove more than I will the larger one, but I guess it would suit somebody that wanted to do a little bit of roasting. But as I say, I did find the oven to be a compromise. In my opinion, it is a compromise. So that's it. I'm just being honest and truthful as to my findings. I probably didn't use the best fuel. Some of the wood was a bit old and rotten, and probably not the highest calorific value. Maybe if you had real top quality fuel, you'd have got a more efficient oven use out of it. But I think that with the design of it having a cold back here and a cold here, and with heat and on the top and heat on the side, you are going to get an oven which has hot spots and cold spots in it, and I think that's just the design of the stove. So I guess it'll suit some people, but I don't think it'll suit everybody. This little stove, on the other hand, is an absolute gem. If you're not going to do any baking and you've got a shelter like a small iron wall shelter or a two or three person tent, then you're not going to go wrong with a stove like this size. Anyway, that's my conclusions on the two stoves. kittens.